Donald Trump is scheduled to hold yet another rally, this time in Erie, Pennsylvania. Now, there are some issues though, because previously he ran up a tab in various parts of the country for his rallies, and then his campaign didn't pay the bill. So there are some concerns here. The mayor of Erie really, really wants Trump's campaign to pay for the rally in advance because the campaign still owes the city of Erie $35,000 for a rally that was held in 2018. So, what's the charge? Well, the Trump campaign paid a fee of $17,000 to rent the Erie Insurance Arena for the rally, but the extra $35,000 was required to pay the city employees who actually worked overtime at that rally. Now, at the time of the rally, the Trump campaign had very little money, okay? They were struggling, to be fair. And when I say very little money, I mean that the Trump campaign had $35.4 million on hand, cash on hand. They had paper, but they didn't want to pay their bills.
So 35,000, I did the math on it, is 0.1%, and he still didn't want to do it.
It's so crazy. Why? Just pay the $35,000.
No, because it's in his bones, it's in his DNA.
God.
He's a natural born con man, and he wants to rip off everyone he has contact with. He does it in almost every instance. That's why lawyers, he can't get a lawyer for his incredibly important cases, because he never pays his lawyers. I mean, of all the people in the world to pay, you gotta pay the lawyers so they'll keep you out of jail. He won't even do that.
And remember, I mean, he had gone bankrupt so many times that US based banks just refused to lend to Trump, which is why, you know, toward the end, he was just relying on Deutsche Bank in order to 100%. Get the loans.
And he brags about it. You guys have heard it. I mean, a lot of people have heard that in 2016, they're like, oh, you went bankrupt six times, right? And he's like, oh, that's just what a smart businessman does. No, a smart businessman makes a profit, you knucklehead. But he thinks, and he explains it. He goes, well, that way I got the money and then I didn't pay them back. That's smart. No, that's called being a crook. So, and when you do, and you do it to bankers in America, nobody's gonna shed a tear. I get it, right? Although it's not the right thing to do, generally. But when you do it to cops and firemen and random average Americans in Erie, Pennsylvania, because you didn't want to give him $35,000, as your PAC has 22 million right now. I'm sorry, his campaign does. His PACs have hundreds of millions of dollars. And he won't pay them because he's a natural born crook. He wants to rob everyone he meets.
So the mayor of Erie, Joe Schember, said this regarding this year's rally, quote, I think we have to try, and I feel like my team feels the same way. We're going to see whether we can get some payment from them in advance this time. It's important to do this because we're talking about taxpayer money being used to help make his visit more safe, right? So like he is ripping off the taxpayers in Erie, Pennsylvania, when he and the workers who work the event when he refuses to pay what he owes. And by the way, the mayor should not get his hopes up. In 2020, for instance, Trump's campaign owed nearly $2 million to 14 cities across the country to cover police and public safety costs. And that's according to Newsweek. The latest, or largest, I should say, amounts owed at the time were to El Paso and Minneapolis, Minnesota, to which he owed $542,733.
So look, think about how counterproductive this is. He's going to Pennsylvania, he wants to win Pennsylvania. He's in, I think, Trump territory in Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. And this is going to be in all the papers in Erie, Pennsylvania. He's going to do the rally there. So then the rally becomes counterproductive. Now, are tons of MAGA people going to leave him for this? No, they won't leave him under any circumstance, right? But will it cost him some votes around the edges for some Republicans and mainly independents? Yeah, of course, any negative news costs you a little bit of votes, right? Then why are you going to do something counterproductive when it's gonna cost you 0.1%? Because he can't help himself. Do you remember the story from a couple of weeks ago? He goes into a restaurant and he's like, yeah, you know, everything's on me. And then he runs out and he doesn't pay. And then people like are like, oh yeah, it's on Trump. And then they get drinks and more food. And then at the end, they're like, no, he was just lying. You guys have to pay it. And they're like, what? Because okay. He's a crook. No. He can't help himself.
Armenians have a word for that. Amot. Okay, he's Amot, that's what he is, okay? Unbelievable that he would do that and just kind of like get away with it.
He keeps getting away with it because MAGA's like, yeah, slap me across the face, I love it. Here,
some
take my wife.
Are into that. I mean,
yeah. Here, take my money, rob me.
Folks, I guess, but
it's look, for MAGA, it's almost become a kink.
I mean, do you booze? But like, what about the other taxpayers in your city? I mean, it's not right for them to get ripped off by the former president of the United States, who's running for president yet again.
You know, look, they love that he's a quote unquote alpha in their minds. But guys, if you're MAGA, what does that make you? So at one rally, he pulled a guy who was just dressed like him and he pulled him up to the stage and it looked like it was gonna be a lovely moment. I was gonna say, hey, you know what? That's a nice little populist shtick he's got going. Okay, we're our job is to do honest analysis. And we tell you often, unfortunately, that Trump is pretty good at politics because he doesn't seem fake like the other politicians. But anyway, in this case, he pulls the guy onto the stage and he's like, oh, I bet your wife would like the real deal better.
Oh my God, Jesus.
And the crowd goes, he cocked him. He cocked him. And the guy's like, yeah. Jesus, man. That's why I say it might be a kink. So does that make you guys the betas to his alpha? And do you enjoy that? Because guys, he's not robbing us. The number one people that he robs are the people who trust him the most. He did Trump University, Trump Charity. People trusted him and then he ripped them off. And he had to pay a $25 million settlement because it was a scam. And he didn't give them an actual education in real estate or anything else. He didn't use it for charity, he used it to buy portraits of himself. I mean, the guy's a both disgusting and hilarious con man. And what is he doing with the campaign money? He takes all your campaign money. He didn't pay the legal fees of any of the January 6th guys, even though he did a legal fund. And instead, he takes the campaign money and he increases the rent on his properties and pretends that his campaign is in Trump Tower and charges four times what he used to charge. That's your money he's ripping off if you're a MAGA. Are you into it? Are you a beta who's like, yes, punish me again, Donald? If you are, okay, have at it, Hoss, to each his own, right? But stop ripping off the average taxpayer. You have tons and tons of money. Didn't you get elected because you were a rich billionaire? And that was your main claim to fame?
No, I mean, this is definitely the kind of behavior you should expect from a billionaire, you know?
And you know, MAGA, if Biden had done 1% of this, they'd be like, what a monster!
No. Let's just be clear. If Biden had done 1% of this, we would be on our show calling him a monster.
Of course. That's the difference. That's the difference.
But integrity doesn't get rewarded in American society. Yeah, just keep it real.
So MAGA, this is your, you know, you created this Frankenstein. Enjoy. Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.